Hi all. I've been getting some questions lately about how to get started in the Millenaire Mod. Basic things like how you sell, how you check your reputation, how you buy a home, all that kind of stuff. So I'm going to kind of give a quick walkthrough of how you get started. So as you can see, I've only got a couple things in my inventory. I've picked up some sand, and since I'm still playing the previous version of Minecraft, I haven't updated yet. I'm still able to punch sheep. So I've run around and grabbed some cotton, some wool, to kind of demonstrate how that works, how you sell that to the NPCs. So basically, in the Millenaire mods, the chores are divvied up by gender. Women, like this one here, are the ones that handle the shops. The men are the ones that handle the chores around of that particular home, such as this is the farm. So in this home, the male NPC, who's not here right now, but he'll be the one that'll actually be tending to the wheat, gathering it, etc. The woman will be the one that takes it from the chest and delivers it wherever it needs to go. In some cases, in some villages, that's the bakery. Sometimes she just stands there and makes it into bread herself. But that's usually how it works. So that means even in the town hall, which is what this is, the woman is the one that will be handling interactions with the player. So as you can see, as I approach this chest under this collection of signs, I get that text from her that she'll be right here. So you right-click on her, and then you have this menu. This is the selection of things that they will sell. Now, right now, I don't have any money, so it's telling me that I'm missing denier? Denier? Not sure how to say it. Anyhow, this second set of rows is what they will buy from me. And down here, obviously, is your standard inventory and quick slots, like you usually see. So if I sell them one wool, left-click, they've given me 8 for it, as it says when you hold your mouse over to see the tooltip. Now I'd be able to buy wood. It's 2 a piece. So I buy with a left click, and you can see I've gone down in cash, but I've acquired that. And they'll buy it back for 1. So you lose money on that deal. Now, if you want to sell more than one at a time, you hold control. And that'll sell an entire stack worth, or everything that you have if it's less than a stack. So holding down control with a single left click sold all 12 at the same time. Or all 11, excuse me. So now you see I have another tier. It's, just like dollars and cents in a way that, you get enough of this, you get one of these. You get enough of this, you'll get a gold one. Pretty straightforward. Now, you can also interact with some of these signs. Now, obviously, there's the map of the village at the very top, and that enables you to mouse over each of the structures, and it'll tell you what it is. And you can also mouse over the NPCs. If you scroll to the next page, it kind of gives you the key, the legend to what all of those things are displayed on the map. If you right-click on the construction project listing, it tells you all the buildings it's got. It has this one. It started with these. Player buildings are obviously not built yet. It just started this map. And these are things that it will undertake. And then secondary buildings and extras, etc. So once a building is constructed, it gives you the directions. It's 7 meters to the north, which basically just means, I'm at it. And there are 10 upgrades left. Now this map or this sign will give you a breakdown of the villagers, their names. You can kind of guess gender from it, but it'll also break down for you their profession. And this tells you obviously what they were working on. They're doing nothing right now. And this gives you a full breakdown of all of their resources across all of their chests, because you can click on the chest, but it only tells you what's in this one immediately in front of you. And as you can see, there are a lot of them around. And as you continue to trade with a town, they really start to amass a great deal of wood, in my experience. So and you can see there are some things they buy from you, but they don't sell back. So you have to be fairly careful. Like this one in particular will buy white wool from me, but they won't buy the other shades of wool. I'm not really sure why that is, why it's even on here, how they would even acquire it, but one of the mysteries. So let me try to find the head of the village. Now, in several different kinds of towns, the name seems to be different. I think the first name on that list of the villagers, let me go back to it, was actually the one that's this particular town's leader. Yes, this one up here. That's the name of the leader in this town. Sometimes it's a different name, and this is him. So this is the gentleman you interact with when you are interested to buy a player house or just check on your reputation. So you right-click on him, and it shows you his name, he tells you he's the head of the village and the name of it. This is my reputation status right as of now. I've only sold them a handful of things, so they're still wary of me. And this is the list of things that you can purchase from them as you increase your reputation. So right now it says it's not available. I haven't gotten that far. I need to increase my reputation with them. Once I have done that, there will be little icons that start to appear in this bottom corner, and I believe they take the shape of a little house. And that's how you purchase. So the one to the furthest left will be the first, the Petit Terrain, I don't know. And then to the right goes down the list. And once they start to appear, you'll actually be able to see the value of them. So I'm going to cut here, and when I pick up again, I will be on another map where I actually can purchase those items. So now we're here on another map, and as you can see, when I speak to this particular town's leader, these two, plot and house, are available. I've earned reputation enough with them. I'm a favorite trader. So when you mouse over, you can get more details such as the cost. Now if I one left click, and you can see it's changed, and I've received a message in my chat window that construction will start shortly. And they take care of all the construction other than the fact that they might need materials. As of right now, I get this a lot where it doesn't pick up right away. So I have to jump out of it, come back in, and it updates. Now it says in construction, and the only thing it needed was 9 planks of wood, or 9 pieces of wood with which to make planks. So here comes the female who does all the construction. She's grabbed the stuff she needs. Let me go look at the map. They're building for me back here. Let's go look. Oops, got turned around with a lag. Probably won't be building long since the sun is setting. Nope, didn't stay long. But you can see the sign here in construction. It's a small plot. So when I come back here tomorrow, she will have that completed. Now, some of the other questions I get tend to pertain to the farms, like this one. This is a chicken and sheep farm. Now, obviously, it's nighttime, so they've spawned. Now, what I've read in the wiki is that because of these torches, that's the reason they can spawn at night, and I never see them during the day, so I think that that's deliberate. But it does allow you to come in here and farm pretty well. And in some of the towns, the wool sells for a good chunk of change, and they come back pretty quickly. So you risk your safety sometimes with the mobs that wander around at night, but if you choose to hang out in any of these overnight, you can farm yourself some resources. And sometimes they spawn in odd places like that, in the middle of the wall, and kill themselves. I'm not sure. I why or how that works. I believe the other type of farm like that is a bovine cow farm. I think this one over here is. Yeah, you can hear them. So it's the same deal in here. They've already killed themselves somehow by spawning in the walls. But you can stand in here. The villagers don't get mad. And just farm yourself, grind out some leather, and make your first set to protect yourself when you get started if you want. I like, because I have not updated to the new version of Minecraft with the shears, I like to be able to sit and farm sheep on the first night for cotton and grind up a good bit of money that way to start off with. Most of the villagers buy it for a pretty good price. So I'm actually going to sleep through the night if I can find a way to do that, and pick it up with that NPC building the terrain, the plot for me. And when she's done with that, see if I can get them to build the next one. Let me go buy it from him now. Where is he? Alright, he's downstairs again, it looks like. Yep, still here. Alright, so that's requested. Construction's at 0%, so I'll want to go see how that's going. Yeah, she hasn't even gotten started. So, I will pause it again and come back when she begins construction, or at least in when the construction updates on that board, so you can see the type and amount of materials that you'll need for the small house. Okay, back in the town hall, you can see that in order to build the small house, it takes 20 glass, 84 wood, 3 wool, and 66 cobblestone. I might have that cobblestone. I do. So again, holding control and left clicking sells stacks at a time, and if you have less than a stack, it sells everything you got. So now they're all set. They're building that next to the plot. And yep, here comes the woman to collect those mats for building. And in a previous video, I've already kind of given a quick tour of what the other properties look like. You can see the largest house there in the distance with the trees framing it. I'm on that map again. Gunpowder. It seems as though the mod just outright kills creepers when they spawn too close to existing villages. So, a lot of times you just get to wander around and collect free gunpowder. So, I hope that answers a lot of questions. If you have any others, leave them in the comments or send me a message. I will try to get back to you quickly. That should cover the gist of it. Once you find your village, which of course you do by pressing V, you can see they all appear in your chat window that way. Now the first thing I do, because I'm on the old version of Minecraft, is I punch some sheep and get a good stack of coin started. And selling to them increases your reputation, so selling them as much wool as you can amass, and then wood, and then cobblestone, should get your rep going, and they'll be able to sell you some property pretty quickly that way. I hope this was informative, and I thank you for watching.